In part two of our lesson on graphs of tangent and cotangent, we will create the graph of cotangent. We know that cotangent of x is equal to cosine of x divided by the sine of x. So much like we did for our graph of tangent, we're going to use the property about vertical asymptotes, where we know that the vertical asymptotes are when the denominator is going to equal 0, but the numerator is not equal to 0. So looking at our graph of sine of x, we see it has roots at negative 2 pi, pi, 0, pi, and 2 pi. And as long as cosine does not equal 0 there, these will be vertical asymptotes. And we see everywhere sine is 0, cosine is not 0. If sine is 0, cosine is not. Sine is 0, cosine is not. And that happens everywhere on the graph. So we can feel comfortable that everywhere sine is 0, the cotangent graph is going to have a vertical asymptote. So let's move forward and put those on our graph. Cotangent will have a vertical asymptote then at negative 2 pi, negative pi, 0, pi, and at 2 pi. We're ready now to build up our graph of cotangent, so let's pick a few x values and plot some points here. If we pick x is pi over 4, we know that the cotangent of pi over 4 is equal to 1. If x is pi over 2, the cotangent of pi over 2 is 0. The cotangent of 3 pi over 4 is equal to negative 1. So you can see this is going to be similar to the tangent graph. We start from that middle point and make one smooth curve approaching the asymptote in the positive direction, and then we'll start again from the middle point and make one smooth curve approaching the asymptote in the negative direction. And this is one full cycle of cotangent. We know cotangent of 5 pi over 4 is equal to 1. Cotangent of 3 pi over 2 is equal to 0. And cotangent of 7 pi over 4 is negative 1, so we can see it's already repeating itself. Now we can go ahead and fill in the rest of the graph. Cotangent of negative 3 pi over 4 is 1. At negative pi over 2, it's 0. And at negative pi over 4, it's negative 1. Make the smooth curves. And we can fit one more cycle in here. At negative 7 pi over 4, it's 1. At negative 3 pi over 2, 0. And at negative 5 pi over 4, it's 1. Now we're ready to analyze this graph a little. We see that the period, we can subtract an ending value minus the beginning value, so pi minus 0 tells us that the period is equal to pi. The domain, certainly there are values we cannot plug in. Everywhere there's an asymptote, we cannot plug those values in. And the asymptotes are at negative 2 pi, negative pi, 0, pi, and 2 pi. So then the domain is that x cannot be those integer values of pi. Like the tangent, we see that the y values go forever in the positive direction and the negative direction, so the range is all real numbers, negative infinity to positive infinity. The formula for the vertical asymptotes we pretty much get for free from the domain, because everywhere the domain x values cannot exist, the reason they cannot exist is because there is a vertical asymptote exactly there. So the formula for the vertical asymptotes is that x is equal to n pi. The normal cycle for the graph, the piece of the graph that we pick, is from 0 to pi. So this is our normal cycle. We can figure out the values for n we have to pick to get the vertical asymptotes. The first vertical asymptote of the normal cycle is at 0, so we would need to plug in 0 for n, and if we did that, we would get x is equal to 0. To get the asymptote at pi, we see we're going to need to plug in 1 for n, and then we'll get that asymptote there at pi. So there's our graph of cotangent of x. We can make a little summary chart here. For tangent, we said the period is pi. The domain was that x cannot equal pi over 2 plus n pi. The range is negative infinity to positive infinity. The formulas for the vertical asymptotes are that x is equal to pi over 2 plus n pi. And then remember, we plugged in n was equal to negative 1 and 0 for the normal cycle. And the normal cycle for tangent goes from negative pi over 2 up to positive pi over 2. For cotangent, we found that the period was also pi. The domain was that x cannot equal n pi. The range was negative infinity up to positive infinity. The formula for the vertical asymptotes is that they occur at x equals n pi. And to get the vertical asymptotes of the normal cycle, we know we plugged in n is equal to 0 and 1. And the normal cycle occurred from 0 to pi. That's the piece of the graph we chose to use.